It's Maria Abando. My partner's name is Ellie Dahl, and today we're going to be presenting on an issue related to Chipotle Mexican Grill. Can we start over? The purpose of this presentation is for us to go over some information that will allow us to evaluate this viral outbreak that took place in 2015. Just by a quick raise of hands, who's familiar with this issue? Okay, so I can see that you've been to Chipotle before and that you are very familiar with what happened. If not, we're going to get familiar today. This is the agenda that we will be covering. First, we would like to start with a very brief general background of the company. Secondly, we would like to go over the issue at hand, which is the viral outbreak that took place. Third, we would like to evaluate the impact that this outbreak has had on the company and customers. We would also like to go over how Chipotle has been able to overcome this setback. And lastly, we will conclude with a brief summary. The general background of the company. Steve Else. He is the founder and CEO of Chipotle. He was a chef in California and he was inspired to open his own restaurant. He found a little shop in Denver, Colorado that he turned into the very first Chipotle in 1993. And his mission for this, or his vision for this restaurant, was for it to provide the best food using the best ingredients while holding very high standards for food integrity and respect to animals and ingredients. Also, Chipotle currently operates internationally, not only in the US, also in UK, France, and Germany. As I said before, the vision of Mr. Els was to offer food with integrity. This is basically their three-word mission statement, condensed into a very simple phrase. The Chipotle Mexican Grill is really considered a fast food place because they serve food fast. However, when you think of fast food, you think of McDonald's, you think of Burger King, you think of Taco Bell. And there is a difference here. The difference is that the competitive advantage that Chipotle holds over its competitors is that they're able to offer food that is served with integrity and commitment to the environment, as well as food that is fresh and that therefore tastes way better than their competitors. Unfortunately, there was a viral outbreak that took place in August of 2015 that has since impacted the company greatly. This is quite ironic, right? Because Chipotle is known for being safe, for practicing their services with integrity, and unfortunately, it has impacted the company a lot and has created a loss of trust amongst its customers. And since then, the CDC, which is the Center for Disease Control, has conducted an investigation to get to the root issue of this outbreak. What they were able to find out is that there were actually three different viruses that were impacting customers throughout the country. The first one was salmonella, which is basically contracted by consuming raw or undercooked ingredients such as poultry, eggs, etc. The second one is E. coli, which is most commonly transmitted by human feces that are present in the food, and basically not washing your hands properly and then handling ingredients. The third one is the norovirus, which is transmitted by contact with the human that is infected with it, or a human that has touched the surface and has then contaminated it and then prepared for the vomit. And now my partner Ali is going to talk more about how this outbreak has affected the entire nation.
Okay, thank you, Maria. So let me begin by just showing you guys a map of the different states that are affected by the outbreak that Chipotle had. So it originally started up in Seattle, Washington, where five of the customers were affected by the E. coli virus. And then it trickled down all the way to Baltimore, got serious attention from the media, and where about 200 plus people got infected with the norovirus in a restaurant in Simi Valley, California. That's where the customers were affected with the virus. And then just a couple months later on the East Coast, up in Boston, about 100 plus students were affected with the same virus again. And so not only was the food contaminated in these restaurants, but it was also the poor safety standards that Chipotle had. And then some of the employees at various locations across the country had were affected with some sort of virus, whether it was E. coli or norovirus, and their handling the ingredients ultimately affected the customers. So next, I just want to show you guys a short video on the impact that this outbreak had on Chipotle.
Chipotle Mexican Grill is being subpoenaed by the U.S. Attorney's Office in California. The subpoena was served at the restaurant last month and relates to the illnesses that started at several chain restaurants in late October and early November, the company said in a filing. The lawsuit brought on by the U.S. Attorney's Office for the Central District of California asked the company to produce documents from its Simi Valley, California restaurant. Chipotle has been dealing with the E. coli outbreak that started in late October and a location in Boston due to the norovirus outbreak in December. More than 100 people got sick, but there were no reported deaths.
Now, I will not come back.
The highly publicized illnesses have sent sales and stocks plummeting. Chipotle's stock has dropped some 300 points since its peak 3 months ago, before the illnesses were reported. Producing, I'm Matt Moran.
So besides the lawsuit, that the criminal investigation that Chipotle had, there was also a lawsuit from a lot of customers that fought against Chipotle. And then there was also a lawsuit from the investors because, like you saw in the video, the stock price had plummeted close to about 40%. So there was a lawsuit from the shareholders as well. And so how does Chipotle overcome this outbreak? So the company had implemented a nationwide store closure back in February of this year, where the company told all the employees to get together and were discussing new safety standards on how to handle the ingredients. The company also extended the employee paid sick leave. So if employees were scared to lose their pay and not show up to work, they were now incentivized to take off and not handle the food when they were sick. They also implemented new food handling safety standards. So they had implemented stricter hand washing rules, as well as employees would handle the ingredients moved back behind the counter. The main goal for Chipotle now is obviously going to be somehow to get the public assurance that their food is now healthy and it's safe to eat. And so they have invested heavily into the marketing marketing strategy, and so they have implemented on all different social media platforms. They have now implemented QR scan codes as well as vouchers where customers can go and print them out and just redeem them for free food at one of their locations. So in conclusion, Chipotle had this false sense of immunity. So what I mean by that is their belief was that our food is all natural, non-GMO, so we would not be prone to some sort of virus that you've seen in the last couple of slides. But this is actually a very good learning opportunity for them because now they have improved the quality and safety standards of the food. Now, like I said before, their main goal is to regain the trust of their customers, and we believe it's going to take some time, but eventually we'll get there because throughout in the past, the history says Chipotle's customers are extremely loyal, and their competitive advantage of having providing food with integrity and quality will ultimately help customers come back to them.